What do you say to yourself when you're by yourself about yourself? How often do we beat ourselves up in our heads about how we are, what we look like, what we think? Hello, my name's Jerry Andrews. I'm the body mind coach and massage therapist at Sharn Holistic Massage Therapy. And I'd like to welcome you to this a series of videos. I'm part of several that are on as part of the Leeds Moment of Mass Mindfulness 2020 online event. The Leeds MOM is part of a worldwide program, really, and a movement to bring mindfulness practices and meditation to people who need it. It's to help individuals, help communities, help organizations to try to connect in different ways and to share what we all do together. But also, one of the key things about this, it's really essentially there to help us to stop and to notice what's going on around us, to notice what's going on in ourselves. And in actual fact, it's very, very important right here and now in this current situation with the COVID virus. It's certainly a big, big issue that we all are affected by. We all have suffered some sense of loss, whether it's people who are nearest and dearest to us, and that's the greatest loss of all, or it might be a loss of our business, our work that we do, or just simply that sense of isolation. You know, we are literally having to socially distance, or actually really physically distance ourselves. So how do we actually keep connected? And the work that we're doing this week, this weekend as part of the Leeds MOM event, is all about how do we actually try to do exactly that? How do we keep connected with people? So, a lot of the things that I see in terms of my work is the result of a lot of this sense of disconnect, the sense of isolation that people might have, and the stress and anxiety that all of this creates. I see that manifested in people's bodies, clearly in terms of pain. But equally, it's in what people talk to me about. You know, what's going on in their heads? What is that conversation? So a large part of what I want to cover today is about exactly, you know, how do we bring our bodies into that conversation? And what are the types of things we could actually do? What are the little tools and techniques that we can actually put into practice that are going to help us to notice, help us to actually do something about how we feel? So I'll be running through a few of those things today. And part of that is going to be able to give you, right at the end of the video, the tools that you can use yourself to help when you're feeling stressed, you're feeling anxious, and you might be in pain. And there are lots of very simple and effective ways to address that. So first of all, I just want you to take a moment, really just to settle in and just take a deep breath in and really just settle that breath, settle that sense of your breath entering into your body and settling in to your chest, your diaphragm, your stomach, and if you're sitting, through where you're feeling your weight. So just take a moment just to breathe and let that breath feel its way into your body. And as we sigh that out sometimes, as we might just breathe that out, we get a sense of a weight in our body and a weight being lifted. And often I speak to people about how it feels like when we're yawning. And if you've ever done that, where you feel that whole sense of an opening and a relaxation as you yawn, as you hit that peak of that yawn, it's a big release. And your breathing is very similar to that. So just taking your time just to breathe, just to settle in. And a large part of this, it's how do we actually notice what is going on? And taking the time to feel what that feels like. An important part of this as well is part of the noticing. It's being able to visualize what's going on, where that breath is moving to. Where are you feeling those sensations? As you're sitting, or you might be standing, as you're feeling that weight in your feet, what are you noticing? As you're feeling that weight in the chair, what are you noticing? If you're breathing in, where do you feel that breath? If you're anxious, where do you feel that anxious? It might be a tightening in your chest. It might be a constriction in your throats. It might be a feeling of discomfort in your belly, or a squirming in your feet, or a tension in your hands. Where are you feeling that tension, that anxiety? And does that tension, does that tightness, does that have a size and a shape? Is it angular? Is it sharp? Is it pointed? Is it prickly? Is it large? Is it small? Is it like a tightly knotted ball in your stomach? Or does it fill the whole of your chest? It might have some heat or cold. You might feel a prickly sensation in your body. So what are all those sensations that you might be feeling, that you're associating with all of these feelings that you might have? And what's really interesting is that your body doesn't know the difference of what you might be feeling. You might be feeling all these things, but imagine if you are due to, for example, go on stage to give a talk in front of 50 people, say, and you're not that familiar with doing that, how might you feel? What are those feelings that are coming up for you? And I know for me sometimes, that can be very anxious, and you get all those feelings, the palpitations in your heart, your heart's racing, your throat tightens up, your mouth dries, you struggle to think of what to speak, you start to sweat, your heart's beating fast. All of those bodily sensations are going to be exactly the same sensations that you'll also be feeling if you're really excited. So, if you're a performer, and you might actually be going out on stage in front of thousands of people, just imagine how Freddie Mercury must have been feeling when he did the concert in 1995 for Band Aid, and the immense, incredible exhilaration out there. But that's a feeling of excitement. But I would imagine he'd be going through all the same bodily sensations. So our bodies don't know the difference between anxiety and stress, or excitement, on the other hand. It's the same thing, we still feel the same things. So it's really, really important to take a moment to actually understand and maybe get a sense of what's going on in your bodies and how you notice that. What is that feeling that's going on there? One of the things that's really important as part of all of this is then, what are those stories that we associate with those feelings. And this is where our minds come into play. I was watching, it was a program last night on the TV by Nadia Hussein, you know, the TV cook. And she was talking about her anxiety and how that plays out as panic attacks. And you think, you know, somebody like that who's got used to all the publicity and being in the public eye and having cameras in her face and all that would be fine with it. But she's really, really struggles with her anxiety. And it was really interesting. What she was noticing was that it was actually, when she started to do some work on this, it was the things that had happened to her earlier in life that had created this sense of anxiety. And she associated the anxiety with the bodily feelings that she was feeling. But when she actually realized that actually she was probably feeling the same things when she was out there on stage or in front of the television doing what she does best, that she didn't need to be anxious. She might have the same feelings, but she could actually experience those feelings without the anxiety. So noticing what you're feeling is really, really important. And a key part of what we're doing as part of the Leeds Mom event today is actually how can we be more mindful, not only of what's going on around us, as we need to be in this current climate, but also what's going on within ourselves. Do we ever take time to think about the answer to that question? So, you know, what do you think in your head? What do you say to yourself about yourself when you're by yourself? So have a think about that. And what feelings come up? And have a think about those feelings and see how that sits with you. What I want to move on to now is actually what can we do about all of these things? So many of us will be feeling anxious. We might be feeling stressed, and we might be carrying that tension, that stress. A lot of it happens to be stuck in our shoulders. And I talk about helping people with being stuck, because that's what I see. People carry that stiffness, that tension. They literally are stuck in their bodies when they are feeling anxious and depressed and worried and burnt out and all of those things that are common in our lives. So what can we do about that? So there are a few simple, really simple things which